I'm Nigel Poulton, and this is your weekly Kubernetes Moment. So last week I was on the socials, Twitter I think, and I joined in a conversation where people were talking about kubectl, some of the things they did know and some of the things they didn't know, the idea being to share some knowledge. So I'm going through the whole list and I'm thinking, I use kubectl every day. I figured I would know most of the tips and I was pretty staggered that I didn't. Anyway, a couple that I found really, really interesting, right? So the first one is that kubectl has a verbosity flag. So you can increase or decrease the amount of debugging information that gets written out to the terminal each time you run a command. The idea is you run any kubectl command, right? And you add either dash v or dash dash v at the end of it and give it an integer between 1 and 10. One being like for wimps like me that can't handle a lot of debugging data, 10 being for like the Uber legends. Anyway, look, we'll switch over to here, right? So I am in the full screen view of Magic Sandbox here. And if I just do a kubectl get nodes, just to list the nodes in my cluster, right? And I do dash dash v, and let's go verbosity level 7. Boom, check that out, right? Now, obviously here at the bottom, we get the nodes in my cluster. I've got a 3-node cluster here running on 1.16.6. But look at all of the requests and the HTTP stuff going on here, response times, all of that kind of jazz. And we see the full request headers and stuff down here. Brilliant stuff. So we get a 200 here in a total of 4 milliseconds. Love that, right? However, let me tell you, it goes to a whole another level when you are deploying objects and if you crank it up to verbosity level 10, okay? So what have I got here? I've got a few YAML files. So if I do a kubectl apply against the deployment YAML file and I do verbosity level 10, right? Prepare yourself for this, okay? Boom, there we go. Now I'm just reading this, it goes through, yeah? Oh, that's cool. I never realized that before. Huh, that's cool. Oh yeah, I knew that. And there we go, it is deployed, okay? Now, you might be like me and just read it in real time like that, or you might not. But you get the picture, right? Add the dash dash V flag onto the end and you are quids in when it comes to debugging and troubleshooting. So that's tip number one. Now, the second tip came from Duffy, who is the host of TGI Kubernetes and an all-round legend in the community, okay? And his tip was one that I was actually aware of in the past, but I don't know, I just like stored it in the deep, dark recesses of my brain somewhere and had almost forgotten that it existed. But it's the kubectl explain command with the dash dash recursive flag. So it lets you list any object in the Kubernetes API. It tells you which version of the API they're in on your cluster and then all of the potential fields that you can set for that object and the data types for each field. So if we do kubectl explain... let's do a deployment object and we go minus minus recursive if I can type and boom, there is a lot there. Oh wow, there is a lot. Well, look, a deployment object is a rather large object, so loads of fields, right? But I think first up at the top here, right, we see version apps v1. So in my particular cluster, right, the deployment object is being defined in the apps sub API group and it is GA, so it's V1. If you're running like an older Kubernetes cluster, you might get some beta API groups in there for that particular command. Now, we can see as well all of the different fields that we can set and the data type that each field expects. So strings, integers, maps, booleans, the whole shebang, right? You've got it there. But it's not just that, right? You can dig into a particular field. So if we go kubectl explain deploy dot, let's go spec dot replicas, yeah? We can see again, apps v1 API subgroup. The field is called replicas. It's expecting an integer. And look, it sets the number of desired pods. So pretty cool. So I learned a new tip last week and I remembered an old one. Thanks to the community for having that conversation. I'm glad that I learned those and relearned one of them. Grateful to be able to share it. Don't forget to sign up to the YouTube channel, hit my website, nigelpoulton.com, hit me up on Twitter. I love to talk about tech, share anything that I know, and I guess probably even more importantly, learn a bunch of stuff from yourselves. Ciao.